Welcome back. Chipping of barges along the Kortali-Chikli route is really worrying. The river is immensely polluted with the repair work of barges along the route. The marine species, moreover, are seen washed ashore due to metal and the rust polluting the river. Surendra Madkaikar reports.
बार्जीचे रिपेरिंग जाता असताना जेव्हा ते रिपेरिंगाचे काम चालू असता त्यांना डंपिंग स्क्रॅपिंग करता आणि त्याची कलम सगळी जी दर्यान उडयता हंगसर तिसरी वेळ मेंदियो हंगसर खूप मेळटा चिखलेकरांक लोकल हंगसर त्यांचे पोट भरता ह्या रस्त हंगसर पडल्या कारणान हंगसर हे दर्याचे पोल्युशन जाता एनवायरमेंट पॉल्यूट जाता हंगसर एक एनवायरमेंट मिनिस्टर हेजेर कार्यवाही करतले काय कितें एनवायरमेंट मिनिस्टराक आमी जेन्ना विचारले त्यांना म्हणटा की आपल्याक एकूच म्हयनो जाल्लेलो आसा पूण हे
Have a look at the rust which is washed along the riverbed. The marine species also are seen washed ashore due to pollution in the river. Few people in the stretch from Kuttali to Chikli have their living with a catch of seashells and other fish. But the rust accumulating in the river due to barge repairs is polluting the river heavily. Environment Minister needs more time to sort out the issues.
I'm not too old in this department. It's not even a month. Please give me time. I'm definitely going to look into every environmental aspect related to pollution. Because eventually, when the environment is polluted, eventually it affects our lives. And therefore, along with my department, we will see to it that we take cognizance of everything that's happening in the state, but we need time. Just give us time.
Reporter Surendra Madkaikar for Prudent Media. And now news from sports. Goa's numero uno tennis player Natasha Palha has broken into the top 10 Indian women's tennis ranking. Decent result in two ITF women's tennis tournaments saw Natasha achieved this magnificent feat. Palha played 10 sports 10K ITF finals in May, but although she ended up as runners-up, it was enough for the Akshi-based girl to get to 8th rank. Top-ranked Sania Mirza now better watch out as Palha is certainly eyeing the India number 1 spot. Natasha has put Akshi on world map now after breaking onto WTA rankings.
Natasha Palha, who's passed her 12th standard exams with a distinction, has given herself 3 years' time to catch up with the Olympian Sania. Natasha aims to hit the 700 mark in the WTA rankings after recently getting 900th rank.
I have another 6 or 7 tournaments before December. So I'm trying to reach my target would be trying to reach rank 700 by March next year. So I'll have to get around 15 points more in the WTA ranking. That would take me to 700 in the world.
And how long is a time frame in your mind that you feel you can reach Sania Mirza, who's number one in India right now?
Maybe 3 more years. 3 years, yeah. I'll be 21 by then.
The 18-year-old has had a steep rise in her rankings and performances within the last 2 months. After narrowly losing out to the 10 sports 10K international title, Natasha followed it up with a string of decent performances in a couple of ITF tournaments in Delhi.
2 tournaments after that, you've not managed to replicate the kind of success you had at the 10 sports tournament. You feel a little disappointed?
No, the one after that I made it to the semi-finals. That was a good performance also. It took my ranking higher up from what I got from the first one. And in that tournament also I beat good players. One of them was the national champion. She won the nationals last year. So Rutuja Bhosle from Maharashtra. And then I beat another 2 girls who were, one of them was in the Fed Cup team, Vaishnavi Reddy from Andhra Pradesh. So I played good matches in that also. In the last week, I lost in the second round, but the girl I lost to, she ended up winning the tournament. So I don't think that was a very bad performance also.
What the future holds for you now? What tournaments you have lined up? Any internationals on the cards where you'll be going out of the country to play?
Yes, the end of August I might play 2 tournaments in Turkey, before which I'll be going to Pune or to Spain for a practice stint.
Natasha gained a lot of attention during the 10 sports 10K international tournament. Not only did she beat Sania's London Olympics doubles partner, Natasha also beat another Olympic probable in Sharmada Balu. these results have given Natasha WTA status. The road to the world number one Victoria Azarenka might be a long way away, but the spark in Natasha's eyes has her on course for the journey. Sports reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Prajot Pednekar with Bureau Inputs.
The Goa Football Association will begin the 2012-13 season on 15th August with their season opening charity shield match. The match will feature traditional rivals Dempo Sports Club and Saragaukar Sports Club. The first match will be played at Raya Ground.
With GFA's Dulair Ground rendered unplayable due to delay in completing the artificial turf work, the Goa Football Association has had to look beyond the other unavailable major venues to choose Raya for the season opener. Nehru Stadium in Fathoda will undergo renovation in view of the Lusophonia Games, while Vasco-based Tilak Stadium will undergo repairs so that it will be able to host new season's I-League. This makes GFA's task of managing their schedule much more tougher in the new season. It would have been ideal had the work at FIFA's artificial turf concluded in time for the new season, but the Dulair ground looks unlikely to be ready. Hence, the GFA is trying to manage their schedule for Barde's zone by getting the nod from CESA FA for use of the Sirsaing ground and also trying to get Sangolda ground to host the zonal matches. In what comes as a boost for the smaller clubs in the professional league, the GFA has planned pro league matches to be more of village-centric affairs. Normally, the smaller clubs get overawed playing I-League teams, and without any home support, they usually capitulate. Now, these village clubs will get to play at their home ground and get the backing of their supporters when encountering the challenge of big teams. GFA's competition's calendar looks set, but the new season could be much more challenging than ever, mostly due to shortage of major venues. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
If you have missed our bulletin, log on to www.prudentmedia.in or follow us on Twitter at Prudent Goa or meet us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/prudentmedia. And with this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Take care and keep watching Prudent Media. Goodbye.